Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today I'm going to expose the reason why people say your drums aren't knocking, aren't hitting, aren't banging. It's because there are little things that make your drums sound amateur and sound like beginner. And there are small, simple tricks you can use to make your drums sound more realistic and hit harder. They're very simple techniques. So first thing, let's grab some drums from BusyWorksBeats.com. We're going to go to the X drums. Let's pull up some drums. Let's crank it up to 144 BPM. Go to your channel rec and let's pull up the main ingredient. So first thing we're going to need is a kick. Not all the time. Sometimes you could just use an 808, but let's use kick IH in this case. Right click, open that up, and let's send it to a mixer channel one. If you don't see that, hit Alt M to hide or reveal that number so that you can go to your mixer and add effects to that kick by itself. Okay. Next thing you want to find is a hi-hat or a snare could be next, but let's just go with hi-hat 3 to keep it simple. Send that to mixer insert 2. Then we're going to go to, where am I at here? We need a snare, okay? And we're going to use snare and M because this is the snare they use for trap stuff, trap bounce. Okay, send that to mixer channel 3. And you also want to have some kind of percussion element. So you have your kick, your snare, your hi-hat. But you also want like some bouncy percussion. So I'm going to use the bongo in this case, like Murder Beats. Open that up. And we're going to send that to mixer channel 4. Only thing I'm going to do here with the bongo is fade it out. Because it has a little bit of a tail to it. Let's fade it out. So it's nice and, they say, tight, meaning controlled. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is drag this out. Now we're at 144 BPM, so we're going to be producing in double time, which means we have to spread out our kicks and our snares. So long story short, the snare goes on the 3 and the 7. What that means is if you listen to your metronome, you're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it goes on the 3 and the 7. Now you can also do bouncier snares like boom, boom, clap, boom, clap, clap. And you'll get used to these spots. You'll kind of memorize where they're placed. Clap. Now let me turn off my mic because it's picking up extra signal. Now, if you want to really get fancy, you can add little snare rolls in here. So, like, boom, dip, 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 brr, dip. So let me show you here. So you want to either go to your piano roll, or if you're in FL Studio 20 and above, you can use the graph editor. But either way, my goal is just to turn down the volume. So we're in velocity, and we're just going to turn down the volume for all these in-between snares. Okay, right click, go to piano roll, and we're going to drag this snare that I wanted to have rolled, drag it out a little bit, hit Alt A, and then change your time multiplier. So I'm going to turn down the velocity so it's not so high. So Eminem has that sound, that snare roll sound. Now, you know, he does more than just the snare. Pap, pap. You know, it's a lot more going on with the snare. So that's one way you can make your drums more exciting. Now, I'm not going to overly do the drums and make them over the top, but you can do that. Secondly, we're going to go to the kick. Now, I'm just going to do a simple kick pattern. So a simple pattern is boom, 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 boom. That's like a common hip hop pattern. You can mix it up and do different things. Again, I'm kind of giving you a broad scope to drums here. So for the hi-hats, we're gonna right click, fill each two steps. Let me turn off my mic so it doesn't keep picking up my headphones. Now one thing, the reason your drums sound amateur or just sound like they're not going anywhere is because you're putting everything on one specific pattern. So what I like to do is actually separate my hi-hats onto a different pattern. Some people like to separate via each instrument. Like I forget the control, but there's a control you can use off the top of my head. You click here, you would go to assign, it's somewhere in here. I don't know the command because I don't use it, but there's a command that lets you separate something like this into different patterns by themselves. But sometimes you don't want to have 10 patterns of drums. You just want to have like two. So I do it manually because it gives you more freedom. But anyway, so pattern one is going to have our main drums, our kick and snare. Pattern two, I usually separate my hi-hats from my other drums because hi-hats can change over time. And a lot of people overly complicate the hi-hat pattern. So here's one technique. So now we're getting into the how to make it more like groovy. So go to your wrench tool here and turn up time shift a little bit for your hi-hats. You don't have to do it every track, but it adds a little groove, a time difference between your kicks, snares, and your hats. Here's another technique you can do. Go to your envelope here, and I'm starting to use this a lot more. So what I'm going to do is you can use the whole parameter, but before I used to think that you had to go to piano roll to shorten the length. You could do it right here in the envelope, which saves a lot of time. Long story short, just pull your hold parameter down until you feel like the notes are cutting off. Hear the difference? And it adds silence after the hi-hat, which means there's more energy in the groove. So that's how you can do that. You can do it for the snare, you can do it for your kicks. So just use that whole parameter and just pull it down. Now these sounds are already short to begin with, but when you make them a little bit shorter, they're a little bit more bouncy. And such like a small little change with the whole parameter can make the drum sound way different. Now these drums are already short, but if I had long drums, you'd be able to really tell. But for a kick, sometimes you have to let the kick kind of ride out or else it won't have the same boominess. But now the drums are a little bit tighter. This is emulating a gate expander if you're into mixing. So let's add a bongo. Let's go to pattern three and add that bongo. So notice I'm keeping it simple, but I'm also thinking as if this were real drums. So I was trying to get the bongo rhythm. So we're going to add that time shift to the bongo. Also, let's use that whole parameter to get rid of the excess. This might need to ring out a little bit. Okay, so it's just a short little. Now, you don't want that sound all the time, but most of the time for hip hop. Okay, so let me get into the variation. So you're probably like, okay, but how do you make this different? So over time, you want to leave room. So let's do it in chunks of let's do four chunks at a time. So let's say you want the hi-hats to change. You click here, you make unique, you double click to go inside the hi-hat pattern and you change something about it. So I'm going to go back into the channel rack, go to pattern mode so I can hear the hi-hats. Actually, let's go to song mode so we can hear what's going on. Hit control, left click and highlight to loop. So I want to go boom, boom, brrr. Now here I want it to roll. So I'm going to right click, go to piano roll, find that hi-hat I want to roll, grab it, hit Alt A, and then change your time multiplier. Now I want it to roll further, so I'm going to copy this. Now you can get fancy with the hi-hat rolls. I'm not going to get into everything about hi-hat rolls right now. You can change the pitch, you can do a lot. So just small little changes. That's why I separate my hi-hats from my drums, because nothing changed about the main drums, but the hi-hat changed. But what I want to do is change the main drums on pattern four. So let's make that fourth pattern unique. Double click, X out the piano roll, go to your channel rack. Now I want to add double kicks here. So boom, 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 boom. So I'm adding more kicks here. You can add a drum fill, which is boom, 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 boom. Or you could do boom, boom, sh, boom, 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 boom. You could do anything. You could do a snare roll, boom, boom, sh, boom, boom, brr, sh, dr, dr, dr. You could do whatever you want. But the idea is that you're changing it at the fourth thing. Okay, so it goes hi-hat one, hi-hat two, hi-hat one, hi-hat two. You can even change your hi-hats if you want. But then it goes drum one, drum one, drum one, drum two. It changes at the end. Now lastly, one thing people are omitting is transition effects. You don't have to use effects. Sometimes you could just use an open hi-hat or like a reverse cymbal. This is pretty loud, but let's add this in. Okay, let's turn this down a little bit. You can also reverse this, so like go to channel settings and just hit reverse. I like to use samples in the playlist now. It's just a lot easier to see. So now this noise is building up, but in reverse. And now it's getting people ready for the drop. So that's what people are forgetting. Let's make this unique. Go to channel settings, re-reverse it so it's back to normal. Now make sure that I didn't notice there was a little gap here. So I'm going to make sure that I'm hitting Alt, left click, just to make sure that the noise goes all the way to the end there so it doesn't just stop. But let's go back to the beginning. So now your drums won't sound super repetitive anymore. So let me kind of create a section. Also, when you have these small changes, you can now create changes. That made no sense. With these small changes, I meant to say you can arrange, that's what I meant to say. Hit Alt, left click at the end, and you can hide the ending of the drums. And then when you have your bass, you can bring it in there so it's a little more effective. Might as well do it here since we're here. Now I'm not gonna spend too much time mixing everything right now because I don't have that much extra time here, but I know this needs to be tuned to A from memory. So I want to boom, 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 boom. So this one, make sure you hit Alt, left click to restore your velocity. So let me get the. So I'm going to do the same thing with my 808. So I don't want my 808 to ring out, so I'm going to use the envelope here, turn the hold parameter on, turn everything else down, and now we'll only last for the amount of time you let it in the piano roll. Let's pull this down an octave. Also, another trick is use a little time shift on your 808. This is also becoming like a sound for ATL style hip hop. So let's hear it. So now it's like that stop and go feel for your 808s. Now I can mix it and make it more distorted sounding. Might as well. I mean, we were already here. Let's do Thermionic Culture Vulture. Why is this tripping out? Maybe because I have... Shouldn't be that way. Should be able to load that plugin. Not sure why it's tripping. Maybe because I have some other plugins loaded up. Let's not use that one for now. Let us use Fruity Blood Overdrive. This is gonna give you a different sound, but I'm just showing you it's a distorted sound. So you can even change up the hi-hats a little bit. Add a little more time shift to add more groove. Let's add an instrument here. This is our plugin. I'm going to add a melody in here. Let's do one of these bells. Let me come up with a melody. I'm going to turn off my mic for a little bit. Thank you. And when you add your melody, now you can go back and add hi-hat rolls and open hi-hats. So now I'm going to play the open hi-hats by hand so I don't have to draw on the timing because they're a bit spaced out. Let's record notes and automation. So all I'm going to do here is go here, hit Alt Q to quantize. Also, if with your melody, go to your wrench tool, turn up time shift to delay the melody so it's not right on the beat. I'm going to add some effects to make the melody move a little bit more. Now you can see the drums accent the melody because they have all those time gaps. Let me show you one more thing before I wrap it up. Now you can spend more time on this, but if your drums aren't hitting, open up a Fruity Soft Clipper on the things that you want to hit harder, like your kick. Turn your threshold all the way up, go to your kick, go to your wrench tool, turn up your volume multiplier. Now be careful here, it gets loud, so turn down your fader before you do this. Now your kick's gonna hit super hard. You can do the same thing for your snare. So if you just want that extra little bit of impact, you can do that for your drums. I like the sound, but I just want to switch it out just to hear the other sounds. That just sounds dope. Now again, you can spend more time on it, add a lot of different things to the hi-hats, snares, and blah, blah, blah. But that's the main reason why your drums don't hit harder. It's all those little things combined. Thanks for watching today. If you want to learn more, join now as a premium member at BusyWorksBeats.com. I'll leave the link below. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.